Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys for tuning in, and thank you guys for liking my page and for all the positive feedback I've gotten so far. Today what we'll be doing is we'll be looking at the Glock 19 Gen 3. I'll also be discussing the differences between the Gen 4 and the Gen 5, and also my reason behind purchasing the Gen 3 instead of the 4 or the 5. So let's have a look at it. Okay guys, here we have some Glock Perfection. So let's have a look inside. So what we do get with Glock is we get an additional magazine, we get a speed loader, and we get the Glock. Also in the same case is our cleaning brush and our cleaning utensil, so you can basically put your cotton or your swabs through here to be able to clean it, and then obviously your battle brush that you will use. We get some instruction manuals. Okay, so instructions for use. I'm guessing this is in Austria's native language, since Glock does come from Austria. And yeah, so these are the instructions for use. Okay, so this is what we get with it. That's great. Let's take this aside, and then we will have a look-see at the firearm itself. Okay guys, so here is our Glock 19 Gen 3. Now, some of the differences that you'll see between the Gen 3, 4 and 5 is the texture. Since they brought out the Gen 4, they have also made the mag release button a bit bigger. And the other difference that you guys will see is on the front, this space for the recoil spring is a lot smaller on the Gen 3 than it is on the Gen 4 and the Gen 5. Okay, firstly, let's just check that the gun is safe. Okay, looks great. Now, for you to be able to remove the top slide of the Glock 19 Gen 3, what you need to do is you need to basically depress the trigger, and since it was made this way, I assume that it will be safe to do dry fire. Okay, so the idea with dry fire, guys, is just to make you used to the draw stroke of your firearm, and also to notice where this finger is, which is very important. Okay, so to take off the slide, we pull back slightly, pull down on these levers, which are situated on both sides, and then you will see once it goes forward, it just comes off. Okay, so Glock 19 Gen 3. One of the biggest differences between the Gen 3, Gen 4, and the Gen 5 is the recoil spring, where this one is a one part recoil spring, and the Glock Gen 4 and Gen 5 basically have a two part recoil spring. Now, something I want you guys to note when you do buy your first Glock is inside the rail slides here on the trigger mechanism here, and also the rail slide areas here, you are going to find a lubricant compound that almost looks the same color as rust, but trust me guys, it isn't. It's basically the lubricant that the Glock comes out with. So can you fire your Glock straight out of the case? Yes, definitely, but I would advise you first check your barrel to make sure there's no obstructions, just in case. Never know what could happen. But yeah, I don't think there would be an issue. But anyway, getting back to the lubricant, the idea with this lubricant is that it is basically to seat everything properly when you utilize this firearm. So I would say take it to the range, go through about 300 rounds, and yeah, then clean it properly and then store it if you need to. Also on that same note, Glock doesn't take a lot of lubrication. It doesn't need it. Okay, if you over lubricate any firearm, what's going to happen is it's basically going to turn into a grinding paste if it does pick up debris and so forth, especially if you are a daily carrier, because carrying it around with you, there will be some debris and so forth that it picks up, especially if it's over lubricated. Okay, all right guys, and yeah, then for cleaning purposes, basically take off your recoil spring, and then you can take out this lovely little barrel. Okay, see the barrel obstruction is clear. And on my previous video with the Scorpio ammunition, it has left a bit of decoloration there for the reason that the tips on the bullets were made of brass. But that discoloration will be worked away pretty soon. I'm pretty sure of that. But anyway, yeah. So that is the basic disassembly of the Glock 19 Gen 3. And just to put it back, then I would like to show you guys one more difference that you're going to find. Okay, so what we do now is we slide it back on here, good functionality, and then in a safe direction pull the trigger. Okay, all right guys, so based on that, the other big difference that you're going to find with the Glock 19 Gen 3 and the Gen 4 and 5 is that the Gen 4 and Gen 5 have interchangeable back straps. So what I would suggest is before buying a Gen 3, go to the firearms company or whoever it might be and hold it in your hand. Ask them you would like to see a Gen 3, hold it in your hand, feel how it fits. My hands are average size, so for me, I'm very happy with it. I've grown to love how it actually feels in my hand. So yes, go feel how it feels. And the biggest pro on the Glock 19 Gen 3 is it is about 2,000 Rand cheaper, if not more. Okay, so I believe the difference can go up to 4,000 Rand difference between the Gen 3 and the Gen 4 and then the Gen 5, obviously. But yeah, Glock 19 Gen 3, I love it. I've had one malfunction previously, and this malfunction was due to me removing the mag. So what I did is I put the mag in, I loaded one into the chamber, and then I removed the mag again for the reason. This is silly, I know. But there was a story of a woman who fired a Colt or Magnum 500. In other words, a very powerful revolver. So she wasn't ready for the recoil. It fired, blew back, and then as it came back, obviously what you want to do is have control of it again. And she pulled the trigger for a second time while the firearm was aiming at her head. She died, obviously. But with that said, I just wanted to make sure that I feel how the recoil is, for the reason that I haven't fired another gun previously. So I put one in the chamber, I shot it off, and I don't know if I was just limp wristing it or if it was because the magazine wasn't in, but what happened is the bullet fired, no issue, and then the casing got stuck inside. Okay, it actually fell down where the mag is supposed to be. But first, on the first shot ever firing this gun, and only malfunction that I have ever had with this firearm. Okay, so from then I've probably done about 300 to 500 rounds, not exactly sure, and then not one malfunction. I've shot in 3 types of ammunition, and I've also shot reloads from an individual who assisted me because we were struggling to buy ammunition, and he let me shoot some of his reloads. And yes, not one malfunction. And one of the things that the people say about the Glock is that the Glock fires everything. I think it might be due to the fact that the action where it hits the ammunition on the rear side is quite hefty, and it does what it's supposed to do. So yeah, for me, Glock, great thumbs up. It's an amazing weapon, but that is my opinion. What I have realized is that there is some marking on the finish. So the reason for this is that I have a Kydex holster. Now, the Kydex holster is what I chose for the reason that I want to appendix carry, and I don't want my firearm to be visible to anyone with prying eyes, for instance. So it depends on the situation where you are, what country you are, and so forth, if you're allowed to conceal carry or not. Here we are. And I don't want anyone else to see my firearms, especially not in the type of place where security guards get attacked so that their firearms are stolen on, let's say, a weekly basis, whatever the case might be. So I don't want anyone to know that I do have it unless it is time to go pew, pew, pew. And yeah, then pull it out and do your thing. But with that said, the Glock has no external safety, as you guys can see. So the only external safety that you guys can see is here on the trigger. So basically what it's about is that I will not be able to press the trigger without this being in the right place. Boom. Okay. So with that said, I was pretty fearful to do appendix carry in the beginning. You can just imagine, because it's aiming at certain things that I'm quite attached to. But what I would suggest is take out your magazine if you have it loaded up with ammunition, cock the gun once, now the trigger is in the ready position, and put back your magazine. Put it in your Kydex holster and you walk around with it, okay? Because now if you in any some way or how get that trigger to be pressed back, then you know if there was one up, in other words, around in the chamber, it would have gone off in your pants. But I carried it like this for, I believe, about a month before I got used to it. And yeah, now I carry one up. Okay. Reason for carrying one up is because it's going to save you some time. All right. Unfortunately, criminals are people that basically rely on ambush tactics. So when you do need this, you're probably not going to have a lot of time to get yourself to the ready position. Okay. Now, with appendix carry, there's one thing that I want you guys to take special note of, and that is the fact that don't do a trigger job. Okay. There have been videos where a firearm has gone off while a guy, okay, after a person holstered it. I'm not too sure if something got stuck inside here and if the trigger was just done so botchy that it went off in his pants. Okay, so if you're not a competition shooter or anything to that effect, then don't worry about the trigger. It's fine as it is. It's how it was made, and happy days. I've been appendix carrying now for about 4 or 5 months and I haven't shot myself. Yay. Okay, so yes, with that said, guys, this is the Glock 19 Gen 3. Amazing weapon, very happy, and I hope I helped you guys in the right direction so that you can choose what you would like for your Glock. Okay, just to get back to the wear on the firearm itself. So I don't know if you guys can see, but some of this gray has been worn off here due to the Kydex holster. Guys, this is a tool. It's not your brand new sports car. It's a tool that you're going to need to use to protect your family or your loved ones. Okay, this is what it is. It's gonna have a few dings and scratches. You actually do get a pin that you could, for instance, can buy from Dave Shear, and what that pin will do is it will just bring back the coloration. Does it mean that it's going to rust here where the pin's going off? No. As you guys can see, I've been carrying it for a while. No rust that you can see. It's just this gray finish will be worn off eventually with the Kydex holster. Okay, and if it doesn't happen, guys, you're not playing with it enough. So do your dry fire, do your practices, get your system that works for you, and most important, your finger. get your finger discipline in place. Okay. And yeah, guys, thanks for stopping by. Okay guys, thank you. That's my take on the Glock 19 Gen 3. If you would like to comment, please, you are welcome to comment. I love some feedback, and then I can also have a better idea of what you guys would like to see in the future. Some things that I'm coming up is another ammunition review, and also I will look at vaping and prepping, something different. Thank you guys for stopping by. Have a lovely day.